Hi, hello, welcome back to our YouTube channel. This is Balakrishna. In this video, I am going to explain class 10, chapter 11, trigonometry, exercise 1.2, question number 3. Evaluate sine 60 cos 30 plus sine 30 cos 60. What is the value of sine of 60 plus 30? What can you conclude? Okay, before go to video, please subscribe our YouTube channel and say to your friends, click the bell icon, give the like and comment. Okay, so here, given sine 60 cos 30 plus sine 30 cos 60 degrees. So here sine 60 is how much? Root 3 by 2. Cos 60 is how much? Cos 30 is how much? Root 3 by 2. Sine 30, 1 by 2. Cos 60, 1 by 2. So, the fractions are multiple. Numerator multiple by denominator multiple. Root 3 into root 3 by 2 into 2 plus 1 into 1 by 2 into 2. So, root 3 into root 3, root 3 whole square, 2 2 ja 4. 1 into 1, 1 2 2 ja 4. Square square root cancel. That is here 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4. So these two are like fractions. Write the common denominator, adding the numerators. 3 plus 1, that is 4 by 4. This value is how much? 1. So here the value of sine 60 cos 30 plus sine 30 cos 60 value is how much? 1. Next, what asking that? What is the value of sine of 60 plus 30? So 60 degrees plus 30 degrees how much? Sine 90. So 90 value is how much? 1. So therefore, sine 60 degrees cos 30 degrees plus sine 30 degrees cos 60 degrees is equal sine of 60 degrees plus 30 degrees. Why? X value is 1, X value is 1. Therefore, both are equal. Next, fourth question. Is it right to say cos of 60 plus 30? Is it right to say cos of 60 plus 30 is equal to cos 60 cos 30 minus sin 60 sin 30? So here, first take RHS. Cos 60 cos 30 minus sin 60 sin 30. So cos 60 is how much? 1 by 2. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2 minus sin 60 root 3 by 2 sin 30 1 by 2. So here the fractions are multiple. So 1 numerator multiple by denominator multiple. 1 into root 3 root 3 by 2 into 2 minus root 3 into 1 by 2 into 2. So 1 into root 3 root 3 2 2 ja 4. Root 3 to 1, root 3 to 2 ja 4. So here these two are like fractions. Write the common denominator, subtract the numerator, root 3 minus root 3. Root 3 minus root 3, 0 by 4. 0 by anything, 0. Next, cos of 60 degrees plus 30 degrees. Therefore, cos 60 plus 30 is how much? 90. So cos 90 degrees is equal to how much? 0. So therefore, yes, it is right. So cos of 60 degrees plus 30 degrees is equal cos 60 degrees cos 30 degrees minus sin 60 degrees sin 30 degrees. Next, fifth one. In right angle triangle PQR, right angle is acute and PQ is equal to 6 cm. Angle RPQ is equal to 60 degrees. Determine the length of QR and PR. So, a triangle PQR, right angle at Q, PQ is equal to 6 cm. Angle RPQ is equal to 60 degrees. Okay. Determine the length of the sides QR and PR. So how you can find? By using trigonometric ratios. Okay, here they given the triangle, right angle and one angle 60 one side. So for this side it is opposite, it is the adjacent, it is the hypotenuse. So here given triangle PQR, angle Q is equal 90, angle RPQ is equal 60 degrees, PQ is equal 6 centimeters. So find the length of RP and RQ. So how you can find? By taking the trigonometric ratios. So at angle P, opposite side is QR, adjacent side is PQ, hypotenuse side PR. So here at the P we can take opposite and adjacent. Here at the P we can take the tan ratio. So what the tan ratio? Opposite side and hypotenuse side. Okay, opposite side and adjacent side, the ratio from opposite side to adjacent side. So here tan P is equal tan 60 is equal, so RQ by PQ. So tan 60 values are much over 3. Opposite, the ratio from opposite side to adjacent side. Okay, so RQ by PQ is 6. 6 divided, come to left side, open, multiply. 6 root 3 is equal RQ. So RQ length is almost 6 root 3 centimeters. Find PR. How you can find PR? By taking the ratio, cos ratio, adjacent and hypotenuse. Or you can take that trigonometry. We can take that by using the Pythagoras theorem, we can find the RP length. Okay, so in triangle PQR, by using Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse side square is equal side square plus side square. So PR square is equal PQ square plus QR square. So PQ 6 square, QR 6 root 3 whole square. 6 square 36 plus 6 root 3 whole square, that is 6 square into root 3 whole square. Square square cancel. So 36 plus 6 square 36 into 3. So 36 plus 36 3 jar 108. Okay, 108 plus 36 is how much? 144. Okay, PR square is equal 144. So PR is equal square root of 144. Okay, so PR is equal square root of 144. You can add as 12 square, square square root, cancel. PR is equal 12 centimeter. So next, sixth one. In triangle XYZ, triangle XYZ, right angle Y, x, y, z, right angle at y, y, z is equal to x, x, z is equal to x. Then find, then determine angle y, z and angle y, z, x. So here, given triangle x, y, z, and y is equal to 90 degrees. So here, y, z is equal to x, xz is equal to x. So here at angle x you can take the cos ratio, or you can take the sine ratio. Okay, so that is opposite and hypotenuse. So cos x is equal, that means cos ratio at angle x, cos ratio, oh, sine ratio, sine x, sine ratio at angle x, that is opposite to hypotenuse. So that is here yz by xz. So that is yz x by xz 2x. Xx cancel, that is 1 by 2. So sine x is equal to 1 by 2. So in sine ratio, at which angle you can get the 1 by 2? Sine 30. So sine x is equal to sine 30. So x is equal to how much? 30 degrees. Next, at angle z, at this angle Z, it is the adjacent, it is the hypotenuse. So here that is cos Z means cos ratio at angle Z is equal YZ by XZ. So YZ is X, XZ is 2X. XX cancel, that is 1/2. So cos Z is equal 1/2. In cos ratio, at which angle you can get as 1/2? Cos 60. So cos Z is equal cos 60. So degrees. So Z is equal how much? 60 degrees. So Z means angle YZX is equal 60 degrees. Here X means angle YXZ is equal 30 degrees. Thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe our YouTube channel and share it to your friends. Thank you.